What is up, everybody? This is Twisted here, and we're going to be playing Assassin's Creed Revelations. There we go.
We can keep him like this for a few days, maybe a week.
Call ahead. Tell him we're on our way.
As soon as we're clear.
Desmond Miles. Your life has changed so much in so little time.
Has it now?
2 months ago, you were pouring shots for bankers and celebrities. But now look at you. You're an assassin. One of us.
One of us.
Isn't that nice? Men and women dedicated to protecting and preserving human life and liberty. Not like those Templars. Cold and calculating autocrats, drunk on power, obsessed with order, all that. We're doing our best to stop them. Yeah. Doing our best. But you remember all this, right? You remember the Animus, the machine we used to unravel genetic memories and relive the lives of our ancestors? First, you were Altair, a stoic 12th century assassin from the Holy Land. Then, you were Ezio Auditore, a wealthy Italian with charisma and a talent for revenge. So, what do you three have in common?
What do us three have in common?
The Apple of Eden. That strange artifact left behind by those people. The ones who came before. You know the apple's power. You felt it for yourself.
Yeah, after all, maybe kill Lucy.
Been fun, hasn't it, Desmond? But that's about to change. Your mind is fragmented, falling to pieces. And if you don't find a way to wake up, you may lose yourself. Forever.
Well, let's not lose ourselves forever.
I got the Animus monitoring system to free up a lot of memory, but even like this, it's still risky.
Desmond will be fine. The partition worked, the Animus is stable, and his signs are good.
For now. But this was built to recreate memories, not simulate entire cognitive processes.
The Animus will do its part, and Desmond will do the rest.
Who could that voice be?
What's happening? I can't move. I can't. No!
Where the hell am I? And why is my hoodie black all of a sudden? Hello, anybody out there?
Just walk right past me.
16?
No, they didn't tell you my name.
God damn it, I'm still in the Animus?
What a shock you suffered out there.
Rebecca! Get me out of here!
They can't help you, Desmond. You're a broken man. Your mind, it's broken.
Broken? I feel fine.
So did I.
Hey.
Look at me now! Let's talk, buddy.
So you're subject 16.
Walk with me.
What is this place?
It's nice, isn't it? We're in the guts of the Animus. The original test program. No memories here, just basic physics, weather simulations. Hello, world. You're lucky someone up there had the sense to plug you in here. It saved your life.
Saved it from what?
Right now, you should be sitting in a hospital ward, drooling and chewing on your tongue. For now, the Animus is keeping you intact. Keeping all your ancestors from collapsing into one big mess. But if you can't find a sync nexus, all those personalities will smash together. That won't be pretty.
A sync nexus.
I'm getting there. Hold on.
All right, well, let's hurry up and get there.
There. That thing is your way out.
You're screwing with me.
Here's the problem. Your brain is hash. Too many ghosts in your head, too many voices. So how do you fix that? You claw your way back into the stored data, you find unfinished memories, and you crack them open. Finish what you started until your ancestor has nothing left to show you. That is a sync nexus. And when you find it, the Animus can separate Desmond from Ezio and Altair and send you home, back to your body.
How do you know all this?
Because it happened to me. But my body, it's worm food now. So I'm stuck here. A word of warning, when you step through there, everything changes. Nothing feels normal. But you are still in control.
Nothing ever felt normal anyway.
Right.
If you hurry, you might make it back in time for Lucy's funeral. What? Oh. I thought you knew.
Lucy. Oh, God. I'm so sorry. It wasn't me. It was that voice. Juno. She took hold of me. She made me.
Well, it's okay, Desmond. She was a Templar anyway. Listen to that conversation first.
Dead, and you want me to act like it's Easter Sunday, do you? How's Desmond, anyway, giving in?
That's enough, Sean.
What if he's a Templar, Bill? Hey, what if he's been programmed? It's happened before.
No, not Desmond.
Right. You would say that. Sean.
I wonder if I could access these yet. Desmond's Journey, Part 1. Doubts. Might as well.
No environments. I can't even feel my own body. Everything's just raw data. So am I still me, or am I some kind of computer program?
I don't know, you're probably a computer program. Oh, shit. Already failing at this. Go this way. And I fall to my death. Bastard. We are taking a journey through Desmond's deep-rooted memories.
Home. I was born here.
He was born here.
Yeah, they called it the farm. My parents, 2 dozen couples, some kids, a community. Hidden away.
And they're and the Wi-Fi was probably terrible.
Small houses in the Black Hills. Right. The clear skies, wood smoke, wind, the stink of gasoline, generators running day and night. I remember. We lived simply, almost like nomads.
So and the Wi-Fi was still terrible.
Ready to pack up and go at the drop of a hat. If we were discovered, if they found us.
See, should have upgraded your Wi-Fi and he wouldn't have found you.
Wasn't much of one, was it? Not a proper farm. We grew some food. I don't remember any animals, though. Maybe a few dogs. The assassins. I was born into it. I didn't choose. It was like a birthright. You are an assassin, they told me.
You are an assassin.
Ever since I was young, they never stopped saying it. You are an assassin. You are an assassin. And this is our creed.
Nothing is true.
What did that mean? A world without purpose?
Everything is permitted.
Everything is permitted?
What does it mean? I've reached a dead end in my journey. Come on, get back down here. I have a journey to accomplish.
Understood. That's the trouble when you're born into something. Belief without understanding. Everyone was so serious. Scared, too. All that talk of assassins, Templars. The end of the world.
Damn it. Just climb on that platform, Desmond. Ah, there we go.
Every man has his limit, I guess. I can't remember when I stopped believing. When I stopped caring. God, it all sounded so stupid. I couldn't hear the word Templar without laughing. Assassin? Forget it.
You are an assassin, Desmond. It's your creed. Go, 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 go. Let's
not get... Ancient war, they said. An endless struggle.
What have we got over here?
But I never cared. Who knew it was possible to bore a kid with war stories? I guess I was lonely. Alone in a crowd. If I could have told them that, maybe they would have listened. If only I could go back. If I could tell them I'm sorry.
Well, you can't go back. If I could do the next one.
It's Sean. Sean, what's going on?
Let me talk to him.
Did you... Hold on, I'm putting you on speaker.
Sean, it's William. Is everything taken care of?
Oh, well, hello to you too. For Christ's sakes, man, have some class.
All right, calm down.
Oh, that's rich. Yeah, Lucy's dead, and you want me to act like it's Easter Sunday, do you? How's Desmond, anyway, giving in?
That's enough, Sean.
What if he's a Templar, Bill? Eh? What if he's been programmed? It's happened before.
No, not Desmond.
Right. You would say that.
Oh, I could go right into Desmond's journey, part two.
Sean.
Days a week just before dawn. Up before the birds. Me and the other kids.
Come on, Desmond, get up. No lagging.
Exercise. Mandatory. A dip in the creek to get clean, then oats with butter and apple juice for breakfast. Ugh.
Well, you had to keep your health up. Ah, crap.
I must have walked a million miles before I was 10. But it was nice.
And you'll walk a million more.
I like those days out in the hills. The hush, the open air, the deep dark of the forest. Crunch of boots on the dry ground.
Can you see Rapid City from here?
No, that's much further east.
Ah, one of those grids.
What is this war about? What are we fighting for?
What are we fighting for?
They never told me much. Just enough. They kept things shrouded. An air of secrecy. For my own good, they said. So we stayed hidden. Away in the Black Hills. If anyone ever knew who we were or what we were doing, there'd be trouble.
They're everywhere, Desmond. They have their hands in everything. Politics, war, finance, high tech, agriculture. People are asleep. And while they dream, Abstergo builds a nightmare.
Abstergo. The first time I saw that name, it was on the side of a bottle of ibuprofen.
Ah. How was that about it being on the bottle?
I laughed when I asked her about it. Can't get away, she said.
We pick our battles, I guess. So many to choose from.
She told me the average American household contains 36 Abstergo-owned products at any given moment. If you tried to purge them from your life completely, it would be a full-time job. So this was it. The global conspiracy, Abstergo. Fingers in every pie. Governments, corporations, universities. Mom and Dad made it sound so scary, but it didn't feel scary. An enemy has to have a face, but all I could see was a bottle of painkillers.
All they could see was a bottle of painkillers. Crap. That almost killed me. Damn it. Come on, just a little further. There we go.
Scared me was the training. Sweat, tears, bloody lip every once in a while.
Focus, Desmond, focus.
How far were they going to push me?
Strength, speed, agility. No excuses.
Couldn't stand it. What was the point? For years and years, I thought some major catastrophe was on the horizon. I didn't know what to expect.
Nobody knows what to expect. Oh, crap. Ah! Those data codes are so deadly. Too close.
Maybe it would have made more sense.
The Reluctant Assassin.
Sean, what's going on?
Let me talk to him.
Hold on, I'm putting you on speaker.
Sean, it's William. Is everything taken care of?
Oh, well, hello to you too. For Christ's sakes, man, have some class.
All right, calm down.
Oh, that's rich. Yeah, Lucy's dead, and you want me to act like it's Easter Sunday, do you? How's Desmond, anyway, giving in?
That's enough, Sean.
What if he's a Templar, Bill? Eh? What if he's been programmed? It's happened before.
No, not Desmond.
Right. You would say that. Sean.
There we go. Desmond's Journey, Part 3, Escape.
Life, to live my own way.
Oh, there's a cube up there. I gotta get that cube. Let's get back over 16 there.
16 years old. Where was I going? No idea. Just away. That's it. That was the plan. Not much of one.
Damn it. Damn it. Maybe this is the way. Yay, found the way.
They never guessed what I was doing. Because I didn't know what I was doing. I just walked right out. Someone realized I was gone. They shouted. I started running.
Desmond! Desmond!
Out into the woods he went.
I just ran and ran and ran. All that training was finally worth something. God, it was so dark when I left. The forest. Endless. I didn't dare take the roads.
Desmond? Where are you?
Mother. Calling out. Begging me to stay. But I wouldn't. I followed the hills down. Down until I hit a stream. I followed that to a river, and from the river to an old access road.
We must follow the stream down.
That day. The summer sun keeping me warm well into the evening. Found a clearing after dark. Fell asleep beneath the stars. Never had a quieter night. Not before or since. Walking, too scared to hitch a ride. What the hell was I doing? Lost in the Badlands for a day. Felt like a week.
Lost in the Badlands.
Endless ocean of wrinkled earth. Can't believe a place could look so dead. I'm gonna die, aren't I?
Yeah, probably.
I'm gonna die here. Finally met some girls from Illinois. So bubbly, so kind. One day drive to Omaha, another to Chicago.
And then to New York, right?
Then somewhere, someone said to me,
if you got nothing, you go to New York. That way, if you leave with nothing, people don't ask why. And if you leave with something, you are one lucky son of a bitch.
So that's where I went. New York City. to skyscrapers and subways, to filth and folly, into the maddening crowds.
Into the maddening crowds.
Sean.